Okay, so in this video, we're going to demonstrate for you how to program a PLU at the scale using a Uni-3. So to begin with, you can see we're currently in operating mode. So we need to get into the menus in order to put a new PLU onto the scale. We'll need to get into the programming menu. So that's 9000 mode. So I'm going to key the number 9000 followed by the mode button. So 9000 mode. So you can see this brings me to the programming menu. From here I'll hit enter to go into that menu, and I see the very first choice is P01 PLU. So this is where I'm going to go in and program that new PLU. So I'm going to hit enter to go into that menu. Now at this point in the game, the scale is asking for a PLU number. And one of two things is going to happen at this point. I'm going to enter a number, and either the PLU exists and will be allowed to modify the parameters for that PLU, or the PLU does not exist. And it's going to prompt us, are we sure we really want to, you know, create a new one kind of thing. So we can see on the two-line display here, number plus PLU. So it wants you to type in that PLU number followed by the PLU button. And so it's very important that you're not pressing enter, you're pressing the number followed by the PLU key. So we're going to make a PLU here. We're just going to call it PLU 477. So I'll key the number 477 and then press the PLU button. So here it recognized that this particular PLU does not currently exist on the scale. And so it wants to know, you want to set up new data? Because, you know, hey, maybe we hit the wrong button, right? So we're going to hit enter to confirm that we're setting up a new PLU. Now at this point, it brings us up to sale one. This is the beginning of setting up the parameters for our new PLU. And there's essentially a minimum of three items that we need to configure to get our PLU up and running. We need to give the PLU a name for the product. What is it? We need to tell the scale whether it's going to be a fixed price or a weighed item. And then we have to actually give it a price. So we're going to start by giving a name for the product. And what we'll do at this point is we need to find the edit button, which is just to the left of the number one. If you happen to have a key sheet overlay on here, you may need to remove that so that you can see the other buttons underneath. So we'll go ahead and press edit. And now we're presented with this particular screen. And just so we understand what's going on here, we see INP. That's an indication that we're in an input mode. It's looking for input from us. 0001 lets us know that we're on the first line of our product name or description. We've got four zeros here. These are representative of how many characters are currently in the product name that we're going to give it. So we haven't typed anything yet, so there's none. And then these two zeros here represent the font size selection that's going to be here. So this means basically we're going to be using the default size, which is fine for now. I'm going to create a PLU for a cinnamon roll. So we're just going to go ahead and spell that out on the keypad. And you can see over here on the right that the letters you're typing are showing up here as well as up above on this two-line display. For spaces, you can also hit the space key. And once you've finished typing in the name for your product, you're going to go ahead and hit enter. So now we're done with that. Now that's an important step because remember, in order to put in the name of the product, we had to hit this edit key. We're not going to scroll through the menu and find a choice that says product name. You just have to know to hit edit at this point in order to go in and give it a name. So it's easy to forget because it's not a menu choice. So now what I'll do, we got two more things. We have to tell it if it's weight item or fixed, and then we have to give it a price. So let's start coming down through the menu with the down arrow key. Here's our sales mode. This is where we decide to tell it, is it a weight item or a fixed price item? By default, the selection is zero for a weight item and a price per pound. We're gonna make this a fixed price item. I can use my left and right arrow keys to cycle through the choices. So if I go to the right, I see that number one is fixed price. That's what I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and key the number one because I wanna see my selection here change. And then press enter. That'll confirm the selection. Simply scrolling to look at your choices doesn't make the choice for you. So you definitely wanna make sure that you specifically key in the choice that you want. We'll continue with the down arrow until we get to the unit price. This is going to tell us how much that is going to be. We'll go ahead and set it for $1.39 for the cinnamon roll. That's a great price. I'm just going to key 1, 3, 9, enter. Notice I don't have to worry about keying any decimals or anything like that. It'll just go ahead and plug those in for you automatically. Now that I've got a name, we've designated this as fixed price, and we've given it a price, we're going to go ahead and hit the mode button to exit. And now it recognizes that we've made some changes, so it wants confirmation. Is it okay to go ahead and save this? We're going to hit enter to confirm that. And then we're going to go ahead and hit the mode key.
Thanks for waiting. I've got John from sales.
Several times here, three more times until we're back out into the operation mode. And we can verify that our PLU has been created by calling up that PLU number. Remember, it was 477. So I'm going to key 477 PLU. And there it is. Cinnamon roll, fixed price, one of them for $1.39.